everyone. I'm Shu Yu, Field Application Engineer of Newton. Welcome to the N031 Level 1 training. Today, I'm going to introduce the sample code of I2C. First of all, you can download N031 BSP from OpenNewton, which is the GitHub of Newton, and unzip the file. Then, you can find the Level 1 training folder under the sample code folder. All the Level 1 training sample codes are under the Level 1 training folder. The path of I2C sample code is under BSP, sample code, Level 1 training, Level 1 I2C double EEPROM, KEL, this folder. The project file Level 1 I2C double EEPROM is the sample code of I2C. We would like to introduce the sample code of I2C, which shows how to access double EEPROM by I2C interface. Since double EEPROM is a device with 16-bit long address, users should write in a 16-bit long address first. Then, users can read data out from or write data into the address specified. We implement I2C communication by setting the I2C control register. Therefore, we would like to introduce 4 bits in the I2C control register first. First of all, the STI bit, which is set by master, can initiate an I2C communication. Then, the STO bit, which is also set by master, can terminate an I2C communication. Third, the SI bit. This bit is used to clear the interrupt flag of I2C. When the status of I2C changes, the interrupt flag of I2C will be set. Then, we can write 1 into SI bit to clear the interrupt flag. Next, the AA bit. This bit is used to decide whether the next data replied to the other side is egg or net. In other words, when the AA bit is 0, it will send egg back. Otherwise, send net back. After the introduction of the control register, we would like to talk about the status register. The status register shows the current status of I2C. There are 26 possible status codes. Users can refer to TRM, Technical Reference Manual, for more details. Each status code corresponds to a specific status. In the I2C communication, the next action to be taken is based on the status code. We take this double EEPROM sample code as an example. At the beginning, master sends the start signal. If the start signal is detected, the status code will be 0x0a. And when master receives the egg from slave, the status code will be 0x18. As mentioned before, double EEPROM is a device with 16-bit long edges, so we should send 2 byte long edges to slave. We need to send the high byte of the edges to slave first, and if slave receives the data and sends back the egg, the status code will be 0x28. Then we can send the low byte of the edges to slave, and if slave replies the egg, the status code will also be 0x28. When we keep sending data, the status will still be 0x28. This sample code shows how to use the while loop to check the status code of I2C. In this sample code, we will be pulling SI flag in a while loop. Besides, we will read the status code to decide the next action to be taken and check if the action of writing into double EEPROM is completed. When the transmission is completed, we will send back the length of the written data to determine whether the data is right or not. In the main function, first, we set the data length of TX buffer, TX buff, and RX buffer, R data buff, which are used to store the data written and read. After that, we call the sysinit function to initiate the system, including setting the system clock and the IP clock, and assigning the multi-function pins of GPIO as UART0 and I2C0. In addition, we enable the UART module and set baud rate as 115200. Then, we call the I2C0 init to enable the module of I2C0, and set the transmission speed as 100 kHz. After that, we write 10 pieces of data into TX buffer first. Then, call the API I2C write multibyte to register, which is already defined in BSP. By doing so, we can write these 10 pieces of data to EEPROM. In the API, I2C write multibyte to register. When the I2C communication starts, we call the function I2C wait ready to pull the SI flag in while loop. Then we call I2C get status to get the status code, and we take actions according to the code. We can also check the status code to confirm whether the data writing to EEPROM is completed or not. After the transmission is finished, the API will return the length of written data. We can determine whether the data transmission is normal or not by the data length. And then we can read out the data in order from RX buffer, which is rdatabuf here. By API, I2C read multibytes to register. The way to read out the data is similar to the one to write the data in. Besides, we compare the data read out with the data written in. If the two sets of data are identical, then we print out data compare done, pass. Otherwise, we print out the failure message. Let's move to the hardware preparation. In the level 1 training, the boards we used are NewMaker N032SE and level 1 training board. In I2C demonstration, N032SE will execute data reading and writing on EEPROM of level 1 training board by I2C interface of Arduino extension connector. Then, let's connect the evaluation board to the PC. First, as we need to turn on the UR transmission between MCU and NewLink to me, we should switch BCOM number 1 and number 2 on. Then connect the NewLink to me USB connector to the PC USB port via USB cable. If the board connects to the PC successfully, we can see the status of virtual COM in device manager. After the hardware is settled down, we need to program the code into MCU by an IDE. We take Kale IDE as an example in the demonstration of level 1 training. In the window of Kale, click the rebuild button to compile. After the project is compiled successfully, we can click the load button to load the compiled program into MCU. For more details about the evaluation board introduction, IDE download, and code programming steps, you can refer to the video, The Best MCU Beginner Course, Lead Your Way to the Newton Development Platform. Then, let's see what's the result of this I2C demonstration. Finally, we can go to Terminal Emulator to check the result. We take Putty as an example here. Select the connect type as serial. Fill the serial line column with the virtual count number, as shown in Device Manager, and enter the 115200 in the speed column, and click the Open. Then push the Reset button on NewMaker board, and you can see the result. Above is the introduction and demonstration of Level 1 training, I2C sample code. Thanks for watching. Please do not hesitate to contact us if you have any questions. You may subscribe our channel for more information.